be a discipline, it'd be written discipline, like, great. But now, we're now up to question seven, and that's Ian speaking. Please, Ian.
You're probably aware about all of the problems around the delayed payments of universal credit and all of that's actually led up to. People getting into debt, having to use food banks, and God knows what, all of the terrible conditionality that goes with having to claim universal credit. But one of the more serious problems is that some claimants run at the risk of getting into rent arrears, and because of that there is a threat of eviction by the landlords. So just what I would like to do is, what would you do to ensure that no evictions actually take place during the claiming process? And would you agree that it would be possible to get landlords, and both social and private, to actually stop any evictions?
Thank you, Ian. Am I doing this now? Well, I'm sorry for you this time, Jackie. Please.
Okay. Yes, universal credit is coming in, and we've also had PIP, haven't we, which has had a major impact on disabled people, and a very laborious process of appealing. So it's a programme that's coming in, it's now coming to Lambeth. I know somebody was showing me the form, it's 20 pages of form you've got to fill in. Very difficult, very. So the policy on rent arrears, well, with the council, as it's can control its own rent arrears policy. We can do that. But we can't control the policy on other landlords. It's up to them. But on our one, we will definitely will not be evicting people whose claims are not being processed properly. We should know about them. But I think it's very important people do tell us. Sometimes people, when they have a problem, it's just so worrying, we don't tell anybody about it at all. So it's very important that you do tell, if you are a council tenant or leaseholder, tell the council that there's a problem there so that we can help. If people don't say anything until it gets to a really late stage, it makes it more difficult. But our policy is definitely to, would not be to evict anybody where the benefit process is delayed.
Thank you, Jackie. We'll come on to Jonathan.
I'm by the council, it's very close to my heart. I mean, I'm the work and pension spokesperson for the Green Party as well as being co-leader. I would like to see universal credit scrapped, and I would also like to see an end to the sanctions regime, and our long-term policy was to pilot a basic income on which disability benefits will top that up. But that's a bigger, a top-level thing. In terms of what we can do here in Lambeth, it was actually three or four years ago, there were a number of reports from Taxpayers Against Poverty and other groups highlighting the evictions by councils across London, the people who fell into arrears after their council tax support had been cut and removed. And we pushed the council for a no eviction policy on that. It initially was rejected by the council, they denied it was happening, and now they've changed their policy, and now they do not evict. And that's a green victory. But we just got another, I think Scott put in a members' inquiry, our councillor in St. Leonard's, to say what are the levels of evictions. Now, I haven't got the stats right in front of me, and I can find them out for you, and this is from memory, but I think it's still about 3,000 evictions happening every year in Lambeth at the hands of the council. So while they've stopped for those that have fallen into arrears because of cuts to council tax support, they haven't stopped completely. Now, I just need to check that figure, okay, and I can give you the figure afterwards. Maybe Jackie knows off the top of her head, but it's somewhere in that region. And I would like to see a zero eviction policy, because I think evictions are counterproductive. They end up levying huge court fees, which adds to the debt and plunges people further into debt, and you never get the money back. It is totally counterproductive, as well as the huge hardship that inflicts on people, both disabled and non-disabled. So that would be our approach. As Jackie says, in terms of private landlords, it's very, very hard. You need a change in primary legislation, I think, to stop the eviction by private landlords. But I think the council could show some leadership in this area, and it should be showing some leadership in this area.
I'm going to break my rule and just come in there. I do think the council, because they're in control, of Universal Credit could negotiate with both private and other social landlords to underwrite any debts that might accrue during that period. I think, I know it's not a by law, they don't have to, but they could do that. I'm going to say, probably landlords may not agree, but I think that should be something I believe that any council should be doing. You know, and around anyone was claiming, you mean first thing, there was a credit. I'm sorry about that, Andrew. And that goes to Charlie, please.
As has been mentioned, the council knows who is on universal credit. The council knows who's on local housing allowance. It needs to be more proactive. Where somebody suddenly stops being entitled to those things, the council needs to be getting hold of them and going, are you all right? Can we help? Are you in danger of falling into arrears? What can we do? It's proaction. Which for too long, Labour and Members have sat on its backsides, searching for the correct word there, sat on its backsides and just being content to let stuff happen around it.